Okay, so last example for empirical and molecular formula adalah example 3. Okay, so let us read the question. 1 gram of sample of compound A, okay, dia tak cakap what is A, tapi dia cakap compound A contain carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, was burned in excess oxygen producing carbon dioxide and water. Okay, so determine the empirical formula of the compound. Okay, so basically, what happened here adalah combustion reaction. Combustion tu maksudnya pembakaran. Okay, so maksudnya dia ambil compound A, dia bakar and then hasil pembakaran tu dapat carbon dioxide and water. Okay, so over here, I will write equation so that you can agak-agak lah macam mana keadaan tu. Okay, so ini yang terjadilah sebenarnya. Okay, so A is a compound and we don't know what is A. Okay, but kita tahu dia ada carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, tapi kita tak tahu the value of each carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, so oxygen here kenapa? Sebab kita kan buat combustion, combustion kan memerlukan oxygen. So if you want to write a combustion equation, you have to make sure over here ada O2 lah. Okay. So, kita dia kata sini pembakaran dalam excess oxygen. That's mean oxygen banyak. So, if combustion dalam excess oxygen, memang kita akan hasilkan carbon dioxide and water. Okay. Right. So, next kita tengok dekat sini. Kita nak kena cari empirical formula untuk compound tu. Maksudnya, A ni ada berapa carbon, ada berapa hydrogen, ada berapa oxygen. Okay, so over here, as you can see, saya dah buat 3 kolom dekat sini. Okay, kenapa 3 kolom? Sebab kita ada 3 elemen over here. Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, jangan tulis CO2 over here, jangan tulis H2O over here. Kalau kamu tulis macam tu, salah. Sebab over here, clearly dia mention elemen. Okay, elemen. Okay, so elemen, kalau CO2 bukan elemen. Okay, so H2O adalah molekul, bukan elemen. Okay, tapi dalam H2O ada H dan O sebagai dia punya elemen. So, ada H, ada O elemen dia. Dalam carbon dioxide ada elemen carbon dan oksigen. Okay, alright. So, sini kita guna yang A ni lah senang. Okay, so over here, masukkan sini carbon, hydrogen, oksigen. Okay, so you might be wondering, kenapa tadi awal-awal example 1 miss tulis H2O? Okay, that is applicable for hydrated compound only sebab formula dia something dot H2O and then ada number depan H2O. So, memang ini kena H2O lah. That is applicable for hydrated compound only. But for benda-benda lain, usually kita akan pecahkan jadi elemen-elemen yang ada dalam compound tu sahaja. Okay, alright. So, next let us fill in the mass here. Okay, so as you can see, mass given, dia tak bagi mass carbon, dia bagi mass of carbon dioxide. Hydrogen pun dia tak bagi mass, dia bagi mass of water. Okay, so dekat sinilah yang soalan ni dia jadi lain sikit sebab soalan ni adalah soalan combustion data punya soalan. So, dia suka naik exam sebab student selalu lupa how to determine mass of each element from the mass of carbon dioxide and water given. Okay, so macam mana cara nak determine? Okay, so jom kita cuba dekat sini. So, first let us try to determine mass of carbon. Okay, so as you can see, carbon only exists in carbon dioxide lah dekat sini kan, dekat produk dia. Okay, so cara dia adalah kita kena guna atomic mass of carbon. Okay, divide with molar mass of CO2. Okay, and then daraplah dengan 2.52 gram tu. Okay, mass of CO2, then you should get carbon. Mathematically, you should be able to brain lah kenapa kita buat macam ni kan sepatutnya. Okay, kalau tak faham, then you can ask me. Okay, so atomic mass of carbon is 12 gram per mole. Okay, and then for carbon dioxide adalah, kalau tak kira lagi, okay, 12 adalah untuk carbon. Okay, and then oksigen adalah 16, tapi ada 2 oksigen, so 16 tu kena darab 2. Okay, so tambah dengan 16 darab 2. Okay, so times with 2.52 gram. Okay, ataupun kalau kamu rasa serabut lah yang dekat bawah ni. Okay, what you can do adalah press your calculator terus so that kita boleh tulis number yang lebih cantik lah dekat tengah tu. Okay, so bila saya tekan calculator for this one equal to 44. Okay, Saya tunjuk dekat kamu satu-satu sebab nanti kamu nak study, you should know lah itu datang dari mana, dari mana. Okay, so 12 divided with 44 times with 2.52 should equal to 0.6873 gram. Okay, so itu yang saya dapat lah. And that is the mass of carbon actually. Okay, so mass of carbon kita dah ada. So, masukkan. Okay, dan baru carbon lah. Hydrogen belum. Okay, so hydrogen. Hydrogen hanya wujud dalam H2O lah dekat sini kan. Kat produk dia hanya dekat H2O. We need to do exact same thing dekat H2O ni. Okay, sama juga. So, kita nak cari mass of hydrogen daripada H2O. So, okay, over here, ada berapa hydrogen dekat H2O? Tengok betul-betul. There are two hydrogen at H2O. Okay, so over here adalah 2 gram per mole. Kenapa 2? Bukan ke mass hydrogen 1 je? Ya, memang mass hydrogen 1, tapi since ada 2 hydrogen, so kena darab 2. Okay, so ini another tempat yang student suka salah. Okay, so please take note on this one. 2 gram sebab ada 2 hydrogen dalam water. Okay, so and then over here 2. This one 16. So 2 plus 16 equal to 18. Okay, so over here is 18 gram per mole adalah molar mass of water times with 0.443 gram. And saya dapat jawapan 0.04922 gram. Okay, so that is mass of hydrogen. So kita pun terus isi dalam table kita. Okay, dan next adalah oxygen. Okay, for oxygen, okay, oxygen you cannot do the same thing like this. Tak boleh, kamu tak boleh buat macam ni. Contohlah, ada student dia suka buat, dia nak cari mass oxygen. Dia cakap, oxygen kan mass dia, contoh dia cari daripada CO2. So, 16, since ada 2 kat situ, so darab 2, bahagi dengan 44. Lepas tu darab dengan 2.52. If you do it like this, salah. Okay, kenapa salah? Sebab over here pun ada oksigen, ini pun ada oksigen. Then how? Yeah. So, jangan pula kamu kata, oh cari sini tambah. Oh no, cannot. Okay, you have to look at this sentence here. Okay, compound A is burned, was burned in excess oxygen. Okay, so that means the source of, apa, the product here, okay, might come from this oxygen here. Okay, so oksigen yang dalam ni mungkin datang daripada oksigen yang dekat udara tadi. Okay, so tak valid lah kalau kamu kira macam tu sebab kita nak mass of oxygen from compound A only, not mass of oxygen of compound A and the environment punya oxygen, tak. Okay, so what we need to do here adalah, okay, kita tolak je. Nak tolak apa? Okay, so now we already have mass of carbon and mass of hydrogen. Okay, and compound A, dia punya mass pun dah diberi. Okay, and kita tahu compound A ada carbon, hydrogen dan oksigen sahaja. So, maksudnya 1 gram ni adalah merangkumi carbon, hydrogen dan oksigen. So, kalau kita ambil 1 gram, tolak dengan 0.6873 which is mass of carbon, tolak lagi dengan hydrogen, then kita akan dapat mass of oksigen. Okay, so kita tulis catatan lah sikit so that nanti kamu tak lupa. So, we need to write. So the mass of oxygen, okay, equal to mass of sample, okay, minus with, tak cukup ruang lah pula, minus with mass of carbon plus mass of hydrogen. So, mass of oxygen equal to 1 gram. Okay, 1 gram adalah mass of compound A tadi. Tolak dengan mass of carbon and tolak dengan mass of hydrogen. So, tekan kalkulator, saya dapat 0.02635 gram. Okay, so we can key in the answer here, 0.2635 gram. Okay, then next is we need to determine amount ataupun number of mole of carbon. Okay, buat macam biasa, 0.6873 gram ni bahagi dengan atomic mass of carbon which is 12 gram per mole. Okay, so done. Okay, next kita tengok oksigen 0.04922, okay, divide with 1 gram per mole. Okay, so over here, kamu mesti rasa pelik. Eh, tadi 2 gram, ini 1 gram pula. Okay, so please remember this one. Okay, hydrogen yang dekat sini, kenapa dia 2 gram? Because of H2O over here have 2 atoms of hydrogen. Okay, but for this one, kita nak cari mole of element hydrogen. Memang mass of ataupun atomic mass of hydrogen adalah 1 sahaja. Okay, so divide dapat 0.04922 mole. Sama lah macam dia punya mass sebab 1 je kan. Okay, next proceed to oxygen. Okay, right, so done. Next, we need to determine the smallest number of mole among all 3 number of mole. Okay, so look carefully. Over here 0.05, this one 0.04, this one 0.01. Okay, so quite obvious you can see that the number of mole of oxygen is the smallest number of mole. Number of mole yang paling kecil antara 3. So, maksudnya ketiga-tiga ni kita akan bahagi dengan yang smallest number tu lah. So, saya dapat 3.4778. Okay, so 3.4 or 3.5 kita tak boleh round off. Okay, kita tak boleh round off. So, kita biarkan dia jap. Okay, kita settlekan yang lain dulu. Nanti kita fikirkan macam mana nak dapatkan number bulat tu. Okay, cara yang sama je macam sebelum ni sebenarnya. Okay, bila bahagi equal to 2.9885. Okay, but this value is very close to 3. So, we can round off lah. Kita boleh bundarkan kepada 3. Okay, so approximately equal to 3. Hydrogen and oxygen tak ada masalah sebab kita dapat nombor bulat 3 dan 1. Tapi untuk carbon masalah sebab tadi kita dapat perpuluhan tu. So, we need to solve macam mana nak bagi perpuluhan tu dapat nombor bulat. So, kita dah belajar before this. We need to times the decimal with a whole number so that we can get a whole number. Okay, so cubalah. Cuba darab 2 ke dulu. Okay, so 3.4778 times 2 dapat berapa? Okay, saya dapat 6.9556. Okay, which is very close to 7. So, berjaya lah. Okay, kita dah berjaya menukar number perpuluhan tadi kepada number bulat. Okay. Right, next. Once kita darab, kita punya carbon dengan 2. Kita punya hydrogen dan oksigen pun kena darab 2. Please remember that. Okay, so 3 times 2 equal to 6. 1 times 2 equal to 2. Okay, so the empirical formula equal to C7H6O2. Okay, basically done calculation kita because the question only asks us to determine the empirical formula. Okay, so next important, combustion of hydrocarbon. Okay, hydrocarbon is a compound that contain carbon and hydrogen. In excess oxygen, okay, akan menghasilkan 2 benda iaitu carbon dioxide and water. Okay. Right, next. Combustion of organic compound. Organic compound means compound yang ada carbon, hydrogen, oksigen dalam dia. Dalam excess oxygen akan menghasilkan carbon dioxide and water juga. Okay. So, this is important later on. Okay. Nanti ada chapter yang seterusnya ada yang guna this information here. Okay. So, now it's your turn untuk buat soalan dekat bawah ni. Okay. So, boleh cuba jawab. Jawapan pun dah ada. So, nanti saya akan suruh hantar lah. Okay. So, that's all for empirical and molecular formula. Thank you. Bye.